Welcome to this channel. In this tutorial, we will simulate the ring oscillator using the LTSpice tool. In this particular ring oscillator, we would be designing a complementary MOS inverter, and based on this particular inverter, we will construct a ring oscillator. Before going further to this tutorial, I request you to like, share and subscribe to my channel below. The odd number of inverters in the circuit which is shown is a closed loop with a positive feedback, and this is called as the ring oscillator. The oscillation frequency is given by the following equation, and assuming that the inverters are identical and n is the odd number of inverter in the ring oscillator. Since the ring oscillator is self-starting, it is often added to test the portion of wafer to indicate the speed of particular process run. So we will design a 11 stage ring oscillator and estimate the oscillation frequency in a 50 nanometer process using the inverter. So the time delay for this particular inverter is calculated by using the following equation, and the oscillation frequency for this is approximately 4.1 gigahertz. Click on components and select PMOS with substrate and place this on the schematic window. Now again click on components and select NMOS with substrate and place this on the schematic window and click escape. Now we must define the BSIM model for both PMOS and NMOS device. So right click on PMOS and define the length of PMOS as 50 nano and the width of PMOS as 1 micro. And we have to save this particular schematic in a folder. So I have designed a folder called as LTSpice underscore design. I would create a new folder called as ring oscillator, and I would save my schematic in this particular folder. We have to make a note that this particular folder must consist of the schematic file as well as the BSIM4 model, which has to be present in that particular folder. Now copy this p_50n and place this in the model name. So this particular model will be utilized for the design purpose. Similarly, right click on NMOS, define the length as 50 nano, width as 500 nano, and change the model name to n_50 nano and click OK. Next, click on wire and connect the drain of PMOS to the drain of NMOS. Next, connect the gate of PMOS to the gate of NMOS. Next, click on component and we have to select a voltage source. So Place the voltage source on the schematic window. Now, right-click on the voltage source and define the DC value as 1 volt and change the V1 to VDD as the name of source. Next, click on ground connection and place this particular ground on the schematic window. Next, click on wire and connect the negative terminal of source to the ground. Connect the wire from positive terminal of source. Right click on that particular wire and name this particular label net as VDD and place this on the schematic window. Next, click on wire and connect the source of NMOS to the ground. And now connect the wire on the source of PMOS and right click this particular wire and define this wire as a label net VDD and place this on the schematic and click escape. Now click on label net and define this label net as ground and place this on the substrate of NMOS device. Click on label net and type the label net as in and select the port type as input and place this on the schematic window. Click escape. Now click on wire, connect the input port to the CMOS inverter. Next, click on label net and define this as out and define the port type as output and place this on the schematic window. Click on escape and now click on wire, connect the output to the output of the CMOS inverter. Now click on edit and select the spice derivative and type dot include bsim 4 underscore models dot text. Now this is very important. If we don't include this particular syntax in our schematic window, when we run the simulation we get error. We get that there is no such model when we run the simulation. So ensure that this particular model file is present in the same folder where the schematic is saved. Next, we have to create a symbol. So click on hierarchy and then select create a new symbol and select the line and draw this in the form of a triangle. Now this particular symbol will be utilized in our future design purpose. So what we do is that in order to place a multiple CMOS inverter, we just go to this particular symbol and we call this symbol in our design purpose. Now click on edit and select the add pin port. Now define the label as in and place this particular label on the schematic. Again click on add pin port and define this label as output and place this on the schematic. Now, click on draw, click on line. Connect the input to the inverter symbol and connect the output also to the inverter symbol. Now, save this particular inverter symbol, and what I would do is that I would save this particular symbol in my library folder called as lib, and I would save this as a CMOS symbol or whatever it is convenient for you. Now we have to also save this particular schematic. So save this schematic as CMOS underscore ring. Now click on new schematic, and we have to call our CMOS inverter symbol. So we know that we have saved this particular symbol in our library. So click on CMOS and place this particular CMOS symbol on the schematic window. Now place this particular CMOS symbol 10 times on the schematic window. Now click on wire and connect the output of CMOS inverter to the input of next CMOS inverter. So you can do accordingly with respect to all the inverters. Now the output of last CMOS inverter is connected as a feedback to the input of first CMOS inverter symbol. Now go to edit and click on spice derivative. We have to include the bsim model, that is include bsim 4 underscore models dot text. Click on label net and type OSC and place this on the feedback, and next click on edit and select the spice derivative and type the following syntax dot ic v os equal to 1. This is the use of initial condition or skip an initial operating calculation. So to set the initial voltage across the output, we simply add it as dot ic v osc equal to 1. Now click on edit and select spice analysis and select the transient analysis. Define the stop time as 2 nanoseconds and click OK. Now ensure that the BSIM and the schematic are in the same folder, or else when we run the simulation we would get an error stating that the model is missing in this particular simulation. So click on run button and place the probe on the feedback. You can see the transient analysis of the ring oscillator. Thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope this has helped your learning purpose. I request you to like, share, and subscribe my channel below.